mathematicians, it's Justin again. Thanks to your help in our last lesson, I made it to the Miaville Talent Show on time, and it was awesome. Ren, Mia, and Bree did a double Dutch jump rope performance, and Uncle Felix showcased his impressive barbecuing skills. I am so glad I made it to the show. Having that schedule was really helpful. It's kind of getting late in the day, but the park is still open for a while, so let's figure out which activities we still have time for before the park closes. Oh, notice how there are several activities with the same start time? And a bunch of them have the same elapsed time too. As we practice together, you'll get to choose the activities you'd want to do at Miaville Adventure Park, and I could choose the ones I'd like to do. We can make schedules that work for everyone. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to figure out what time an event will start or end. You'll also be able to identify the elapsed time for an event. Have your guide to notes ready, and let's get scheduling. Before we could do any planning, we need to know what time it is at Miaville Adventure Park right now. Pause here to check the time on my watch and record it in your guided notes. The hour hand is past the 6 o'clock hour, but hasn't gotten to the 7 o'clock hour yet, which means it's 6 something. Then we can count by fives to start figuring out the minute. 5, 10, 15, 20. Counting on by ones then helps us figure out the exact minute. 21, 22, 23, 24. So it's 6:24. AM or PM? 12 PM noon was earlier in the day, and it will be 12 AM midnight later this evening. So that means it's 6:24 PM. Speaking of 12 a.m. midnight, that's actually what time Miaville Adventure Park closes. So if it's 6:24 right now, and the park closes at 12 o'clock, how much time do we have to explore the park? It may be helpful to skip count by hours first. What time will it be in 1 hour? 7:24. Another hour? 8:24. 9:24. 10:24, 11:24. If I do one more, I'll pass 12 o'clock. So let's stop here. So far, that's 5 hours. Pause here to finish figuring out the elapsed time between 11:24 and 12 o'clock in your guided notes. Remember, a clock is like a round number line that goes from 0 minutes to 60 minutes. How could we use skip counting to help here? Skip counting by five will work, but it can be a little tricky to keep track if we're starting at 24. What if we skip count by tens? We can start at 24 and make jumps of 10 to 34, 44, and 54. That's 30 minutes. So how many more do we need to get to 12 o'clock? 6 more. That means the elapsed time from 11:24 to 12 o'clock is 36 minutes. Did you use a different strategy? Noticing chunks like we did in our last lesson can work here too. This half of the clock is 30 minutes, and then there are 6 minutes between 11:24 and 11:30. Adding those chunks also equals 36. You may have even worked backward and subtracted 24 from 60 to figure out this missing 36-minute piece. As with most problems, there's often more than one way to find the correct answer. Either way, that means we have 5 hours and 36 minutes to explore the park. Let's check the schedule to see what options we have. Looks like these events all start at 7:15. That's good. It is 6:24 right now, so I should have enough time to get some dinner first. I have a few options. Gearbox Grill takes 55 minutes. Gigabyte Cafe takes 35 minutes, and Cosmic Diner takes 40 minutes. Could any of them work for our schedule? What information would be good to have here so we can decide? The amount of time between now and 7:15 would be good to know. Pause here to figure out the elapsed time between 6:24 and 7:15. We know from our work before that there are 36 minutes from the 24-minute mark to the top of the hour. Then we can add those 36 minutes to the 15 minutes in the 7 o'clock hour, which equals 51 minutes. So, is there a dinner option that won't work for us? Ah, Gearbox Grill takes 55 minutes. That's too long. Okay, so pause here to decide whether you'll go to the Gigabyte Cafe or the Cosmic Diner. Okay, time to choose what we'll do at 7:15. We could choose from mini golf, go-kart racing, an escape room, or the digital art studio. They all start at 7:15, and they all last for 1 hour and 35 minutes. Pause here to record which activity you'll choose and the time it will end. So, if the activity starts at 7:15, 1 hour from then will be 8:15. Then we could count forward 35 more minutes, or count in chunks like 30 and 5 to figure out the end time. That means each of those activities ends at 8:50. Now that we have plans for dinner and our first activity, let's check out the late night events at Miaville Adventure Park. They're incredibly popular, and you have to get tickets ahead of time. We can choose from the Drone Dance, Water Symphony, Starlight Hike, or Glowing Garden. They all end when the park closes at 12 a.m., and they're each 1 hour and 23 minutes long. Knowing this, how can we figure out the start time for the events? Let's try counting backward from the end time to figure out the start time. What time will it be 1 hour before 12 o'clock? 11 o'clock, right. So we need to figure out 23 minutes before 11 o'clock, which means counting back into the 10 o'clock hour. We can count back by fives to start. 10:55, 10:50, 10:45, 10:40. And then counting back by ones helps us figure out the exact minute. 10:39, 10:38, 10:37. So the late night events all start at 10:37, last for 1 hour and 23 minutes, and end at 12 o'clock. Counting backwards can be a bit tricky, but as with most things, it can get easier with practice. So let's give it a try. All the activities before the late night events end at 10:25 and are 1 hour and 27 minutes long. So what time do they start? Pause here to choose your activity and figure out its start time in your guided notes. Counting backward 1 hour from 10:25 takes us back to 9:25. Then we'll keep counting back 27 minutes. 9:20, 9:15, 9:10, 9:05, 9 o'clock, 8:59, 8:58. We could also use chunks with these 25 minutes here, and then two more for 27 minutes, still landing us at 8:58. With our first activity ending at 8:50 and this one ending at 10:25, we'll have just enough time between all the activities to get to each one on time. So, what have we learned today besides the fact that Miaville Adventure Park has a ton of fun things to do? Well, now you know that the elapsed time and end time can be used to figure out the start time for an event. You also know that there are several strategies for figuring out elapsed time, like using visual models, skip counting, and addition or subtraction. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to practice working with elapsed time. Remember, mathematicians, in math, as in life, practice makes progress. Speaking of which, I need to practice my putting swing. It'll be time for mini golf soon. Thanks for your help, and I'll see you next time.